back in the 70s or the 80s, when you were working on, denouncing human rights abuses in the context of authoritarian regimes, it was impossible for human rights organizations in those countries to basically be vocal about those violations, because these organizations were under permanent threat and on permanent risk because there was no one to protect them in their own countries. You know, there are many cases of either advocates, imprisoned or disappeared or killed, the same with journalists. You knew that you had to put together some numbers to be given to maybe the New York Times, not your local newspaper, because there was no way the local newspaper or the national newspaper was going to, disseminate the information that you were collecting. The people who were closest to the problem were the one that had the biggest difficulties in raising their voices. The landscape in that sense is so different these days. If today you want to discuss, police brutality and you live in South Africa or in Kenya or in Brazil, you can do that by engaging directly with your government in a way that was impossible 20 or 30 years ago. Working with Global South players is becoming more and more relevant. Now you have very professional organizations there, in fact, engaging in the life of their own countries in a completely different way.